Hello everyone, welcome to the Explain series here at Raj Malhotra IAS. So today we are going to discuss and explain for you a very important topic which has been in news for quite some time, and the name of the topic is the Hindu Succession Act. So we are going to explain the Hindu Succession Act 1956 for you. All right. You know that अभी recently Supreme Court ने एक ruling दी है जिसके अंदर इस act के ऊपर एक बहुत ही important और significant judgment pass करी है Supreme Court ने, तो उस judgment के ऊपर भी बात करेंगे, लेकिन अभी फिलहाल मैं आपको explain करूँगा Hindu Succession Act 1956. जो Hindu Succession Act 1956 है, it actually rests upon what is known as the Mitakshara School of Hindu Law. All right, Mitakshara School of Hindu Law. All right. So there's a old school of Hindu law, जो Hinduism है उसका एक law का school है, which is known as Mitakshara School. और Mitakshara School के साथ Hindu Succession Act 1956 deal करता है, या फिर उसको encode करता है. Before going ahead, this Hindu Succession Act, it is applicable to किन-किन पे एप्लीकेबल है? इट इज एप्लीकेबल टू एवरीवन एक्सेप्ट द पीपल हु आर मुस्लिम्स, द पीपल हु आर क्रिश्चियंस, द पीपल हु आर पारसीज और ज्यूज. उसके अलावा एवरीवन इज ट्रीटेड एज पार्ट ऑफ Hinduism under the Hindu Succession Act 1956. That is, the Mitakshara School of Hindu law, it is applicable to even Buddhist, it is applicable even to Jainis, ya Jains, it is applicable even to the Sikhs under this particular law. All right, this is the applicability. Now, to understand the Hindu Succession Act, we must understand the Mitakshara School of Hindu Law. So, let us discuss in detail the Mitakshara School of Hindu Law. Now, this Mitakshara School of Hindu Law, in fact, this word Mitakshara, all right, this word Mitakshara, it is actually borrowed from a commentary, all right. There was a title of a commentary that was written on स्मृति, टाइटल्ड द नेम ऑफ दैट स्मृति जिसके ऊपर ये कमेंट्री लिखी गई है, इट इज यज्ञवल्क्या. यज्ञवल्क्या इज द स्मृति जिसके ऊपर एक कमेंट्री लिखी गई है, और उस कमेंट्री का टाइटल था मिताक्षरा. अगर आप देखते हैं ट्रेडिशनल हिंदू टेक्स्ट, तो उसके अंदर डिफरेंट तरह के आपको टेक्स्ट देखने को मिलते हैं. वेद हो गए, ब्राह्मण हो गए, उपनिषद हो गए, वैसे ही स्तुति और स्मृति भी टाइप्स ऑफ टेक्स्ट थे जो एंशिएंट इंडिया में प्रिवेलेंट थे. उन टेक्स्ट में एक स्मृति सेक्शन में एक टेक्स्ट था जिसका नाम था यज्ञवल्क्या, और उसके ऊपर एक कमेंट्री लिखी थी, और जिस इंसान ने कमेंट्री लिखी थी उसका नाम था विजननेश्वरा. ऑलराइट, सो विजननेश्वरा वाज द पर्सन हु रोट अ कमेंट्री ऑन यज्ञवल्क्या स्मृति. And that commentary is known as Mitakshara. And from this word, we derive the Mitakshara School of Hindu Law. This Mitakshara deals with what? It deals with the Hindu, or you can say it deals with the succession and inheritance. Succession and inheritance of property. Inheritance of property. कि जैसे पिता की मृत्यु पश्चात पिता की प्रॉपर्टी के साथ क्या होगा, वो किन भागों में बटेगी, किन बच्चों को मिलेगी, that is basically known as succession and inheritance of property. और इसके साथ मिताक्षरा डील करता है. Alright, now this Mitakshara is applicable to pan India, or this Hindu law Mitakshara is applicable, or it applies to pan India. Except two regions. Pan India, except टू रीजन्स जहां पे दया भाग सिस्टम प्रिवेलेंट है. वन इज असम एंड सेकेंड इज बंगाल. ऑलराइट, इन असम एंड बंगाल इट इज द दया भाग दैट इज मोर प्रिवेलेंट देन मिताक्षरा. This difference between Mitakshara and Dayabhag is part of sociology optional, so we are not going to cover this thing here. But itna yaad rakhiyega ki jo Mitakshara school of Hindu law hai, it is applicable to pan India. Sirf do regions cover nahi hote. One is Assam and second is Bengal. Rest it is applicable to all the places in India. All right, Assam or Bengal isliye cover nahi hote because Assam or Bengal mein there is another school of Hindu law that is more prevalent and that is known as the Dayabhag law. Now, according to this Mitakshara school, according to the Mitakshara school, according to the Mitakshara school, the son is the inheritor. The son is the inheritor of parental property. That is, the parental property is to be inherited by son. That is, the daughters are not supposed to have right in parents' properties. The son is the inheritor. And what kind of inheritor he is? He is a co-partner in property. He is a co-partner in property, that is, right from the birth, this son acquire an interest in the property of the family. That is, बच्चा पैदा होने के बाद पिता अपनी property को sell नहीं कर सकता जो पिता ने अपने पिता से ली है. मतलब उस जमीन को हिंदी में कई बार एक शब्द से रिप्रेजेंट करते हैं, इसे बोलते हैं दादा लाही. दादा लाही वो प्रॉपर्टी होती है जो एंसेस्ट्रल प्रॉपर्टी होती है, जनरेशन टू जनरेशन फ्लो करती है. दादा से पिता को मिली, पिता से पोते को मिलेगी, पोते से पर पोते को मिलेगी. दादा लाही जो ओनर है, जिसके नाम पे अभी दादा लाही जमीन है, वो तब तक उसको सेल कर सकता है जब तक उसके खुद का बेटा पैदा नहीं होता. जैसे ही बेटा पैदा हो गया, right from the birth, the son acquires an interest in the ancestral property or the dadalahi property. That is, the father cannot sell the property because the son has developed an interest in that property. The share is not determined. Kis bhag mein bacche ka share hai, it is not determined, but yes, this share cannot be disposed of. आप दादा लाही से उस बच्चे को बेदखल नहीं कर सकते, उस बच्चे को आपको प्रॉपर्टी देनी पड़ेगी. ऑलराइट, रिगार्डिंग सन इट इज क्लियर, बट व्हाट अबाउट वाइफ? द वाइफ ऑफ द पर्सन हैज नो राइट टू डिमांड पार्टीशन इन एंसेस्ट्रल प्रॉपर्टी. नो राइट टू डिमांड पार्टीशन. That is, wife cannot demand partition of ancestral property from the husband. But wife can seek a share. Wife can seek a share among the property of sons and daughters. Let me explain you this thing here. Suppose kariye this is Mr. Khetiram. All right, this is Mr. Khetiram. He has 10 acres of agricultural land. Let's call him having 10 acres of land. This is his wife. All right, let's call her Madhumati. Madhumati is wife of Khetiram. Madhumati cannot ask 5 acres of land कि मैं आपकी पत्नी हूं तो आपकी प्रॉपर्टी में आधा हिस्सा मेरा. नो, द मिताक्षरा स्कूल डज नॉट रिकॉग्नाइज वाइफ टू हैव पार्टीशन फ्रॉम हस्बैंड इन एंसेस्ट्रल प्रॉपर्टी. बट सपोज खेती राम के तीन बच्चे हैं, ऑलराइट, ए बी एंड सी. सो खेतीराम के तीन बच्चों में जब ये 10 एकड़ बटेगा, उस टाइम पे एक चौथा हिस्सा वाइफ का हो सकता है. सो वाइफ कैन नॉट डिमांड इक्वल पार्टीशन विद रिस्पेक्ट टू हस्बैंड अकॉर्डिंग टू द मिताक्षरा स्कूल. लेकिन जब पिता से प्रॉपर्टी बट रही होती है, तब माता उस प्रॉपर्टी में कुछ हिस्सा क्लेम कर सकती है, या फिर पिता अपनी पत्नी को यानी बच्चों की माता को कोई भी प्रॉपर्टी का हिस्सा दे सकता है. क्योंकि जो हिंदू सक्सेशन एक्ट है, इट वॉज बेस्ड ऑन मिताक्षरा स्कूल. इट वॉज बेस्ड ऑन मिताक्षरा स्कूल. वॉट इट वॉज डिसाइडेड दैट ऑन 9th सेप्टेंबर 2005, सेक्शन 6 of the Hindu Succession Act was amended. And what was the amendment? If we talk about the amendment was related to women recognized to have part in parental property. That is, women can demand a part in the property of their parents. This was the recent amendment that was introduced on 9th September 2005. After that, many women tried to claim right into their parental property, but many people approached the judiciary denying the right to the women. They said that the father was not living on 9th September 2005. And that is why this ruling does not apply to those families where father has already died before 9th September 2005. So, the recent Supreme Court ruling came, and according to the recent Supreme Court ruling, the status of women in parental property was not just limited to allowing her to take claim. It was made coparcenary right. That is, now the women has acquired same status as son in the family, and women has got the right into parental property right from birth. That is, the parents cannot devoid the girl child from having right in the ancestral property or dadalahi. And that is why this particular judgment of the Supreme Court has been hailed as one of the biggest ruling establishing women equality in contemporary Indian society. So that is all about I wanted to discuss about the Hindu Succession Act and the Mitakshara School of Law. If there's any other article related to the Dayabhag School, I would be more than happy to explain Dayabhag School in this explained series. I hope it was a good learning experience for you. Have a great day ahead. Take care and stay tuned to Raj Malhotra IAS platform. Take care. Bye.